The reason for some of the changes, many of the changes we did for road force this year, was based on the very positive feedback that we received on the Red Group. Many people liked what we did with Red, not only for the technology, but also the way it looked. One of the things people said was, I can tell it's a Red equipped bike from far away. I don't have to read the logo up close. I don't need to read the words. It has very distinctive styling on the shifters, on the cranks and the derailleurs that make it very distinctive. And based on some of that feedback, we took some of those elements and traits and put them into Force without making it a carbon copy of Red. So as you can see, Force has its own identity with a new logo and new graphics, very bold, but many common features, both graphical as well as technology and materials, coming from Red. So Force is really much closer to Red than it has been in the past. And I'll let Bill now walk us through the details of the product components and what we've done to them.
All right, very good, Charles, thanks. The first thing you're gonna notice is we went from the existing Force appearance, which was a woven appearance, to unidirectional UD finish for all the carbon components. The crankset, the shifters, and also on the outer cage of the rear derailleur. What this does, it gives us a little stronger finish. That's also a great palette for us putting the new, as Charles mentioned, graphic on it. It's a very bold white logo treatment that really helps the SRAM stand out. One of the newest components of the line is a BB30 Force level crankset. This crank comes in at 645 grams and it has the really sweet SRAM logo, which is kind of the SRAM trademark now on our cranks on the back of the non-drive side arm, as you can see here. It really helps separate SRAM from all the other components out there in the market. We also have a really nice two-stage shift lever graphic, and again, we're still retaining the magnesium shift lever along with the UD carbon brake lever. One thing to note that's really the highlight of our system is how adjustable our system is when it comes to separate brake and shift lever. With all the new fitting tools and the dedication that shops are putting to the fit systems in their stores, it's really nice to have something that can either adjust either the shifter or the brake lever. And you're not limited by a shim. This gives you infinite adjustability for the rider's hand position. And again, we mentioned briefly, the outer cage on the rear derailleur is now the UD carbon, and it's still magnesium on the back side of this. So that's the upgrade when it comes to the carbon. The other thing we've done is gone to a 6000 series forging on all of our components that are alloy. It also has a really sweet new Zephyr Silver finish that really helps separate us and really complements the UD carbon finish and really helps the logos stand out on the alloy component. So it does give you a nice benefit there. When it comes to, and I'll just hold these up so you can take a look, but again, the Force rear derailleur, very nice system there. And also the front derailleur has the forge with Zephyr Silver appearance on it as well. Now the brake is one of the newest components in the line. We have basically taken a brake caliper that everyone's familiar with, being the Red caliper forgings, and we've done some machining to it, and we've also added pad holders that are not machined out. So there is a slight weight difference between the two components, but you're still getting the great adjustability that every shop mechanic dreams about when they're setting up a bike, which is basically an external center adjust, makes it super easy to set up. You're also getting a nice spring tension adjust here on the side, which really goes hand in hand with the adjustability of the shift lever. So you can really fine-tune the system for the rider, for the length of their hand, and also the amount of pull or the return they like to have on their system. So again, we have a fully oversized, skeletonized Red forging that we've taken to the Force level. And again, it's a little bit of a weight savings on our system when you combine the UD carbon and also the new 6000 series forgings that we have on the brakes. We're still using our SRAM Swiss stop pad system. Basically, it's our choice of a compound, and this is from Red to Force and Rival. We're using Swiss stop pads. You also have the ability to, as an option, secure the yellow pad, which is designed for carbon rims, and that's also a standard feature that you can order in when you order this. It seems something that's very difficult to see, of course, because it's hidden between the two calipers, but we have really high value ball bearings that separate instead of a bushing, so that you do have a really beautiful, smooth feeling brake feel. And it's also very durable and long-lasting because of the fact they are ball bearings. So again, a really nice service touch there. So again, the brakes are a little lighter. They have a great new finish in the Zephyr Silver. And you have really nice adjustability and setup features on this brake.
Yeah, one thing that became available with the BB30 crank is a much lower weight. In fact, the new weight with the BB30 crank is over 100 grams lighter than the equivalent with the GXP crank. So the price is very slightly different from the GXP, but it's a huge weight saving and performance gain altogether.
So all the features that Force has been known for and respected, double tap, zero loss, and exact actuation are still part of the new Force range.